Let us now study how minerals are distributed, naturally distributed in India. So, distribution of minerals in India. India has a rich and varied mineral resources. Varied means variety of mineral resources are there in India. Resources are unevenly distributed, but they are not evenly distributed all over India. They are unevenly distributed. As in, Gujarat has sedimentary rocks. Assam has petroleum deposits, Rajasthan has non-ferrous minerals, northern plains have very little or no economic minerals, and peninsular plateau contains reserves of coal, metallic minerals, mica, non-ferrous minerals and non-metallic minerals. Okay, now let us see what is mining. The economic activity of extraction of minerals from below the earth's surface is called mining. Why it is called the economic activity? Because we cannot, it's not a free of cost that you bring some machinery and you extract the mineral from the earth's surface. No, you have to invest money, capital into it. So it is called economic activity of extraction of minerals from below earth's surface. It is called mining. What are the factors affecting economic viability of mineral reserves? So since we are investing money in extracting minerals, so what are the factors which affect this investing of our money or our capital fund in extraction of minerals, mineral reserves? So for example, if we extract mineral, we invest certain amount of money in extracting mineral, but afterwards we come to know there are very little amount of less amount of minerals are present in that rock, then our investment goes to vain. So what are the factors which affect this economic viability of mineral reserves? First, minerals content of ore must be in sufficient concentration. So minerals which are content in ore, they should be in sufficient concentration. Otherwise, we'll find impurities are more and mineral content is less. Types of formation or structure in which they are found determines the relative cases with which mineral ore may be mined. So type, their structure, their formation, or is also it also matters a lot. Ease of extraction of minerals, how easily the mineral is extracted, it also matters. And very important thing is closeness to the market. Whether the mining area is close to the market, because from the mining area to market area, this mineral needs to be transported, and again transportation needs money. So the closeness to the market is also important. So these are the factors which affect the economic viability of mineral reserves. Further, we have classification of minerals. Minerals are further divided into metallic, non-metallic and energy resources. Metallic, further they are divided into two types, ferrous and non-ferrous. Ferrous means those minerals which contain iron, for example iron or nickel, and non-ferrous means it doesn't contain any iron, for example copper, lead, tin, etc. Non-metallic, from the name itself we come to know that a mineral which is not a metal, which does not contain a metal. So limestone, sandstone, marble, these are the examples of non-metallic minerals. And energy resources, for example coal, petroleum, natural gas, solar, sun, wind, tide, these are the energy resources.